Lafayette used a total team effort to record an emotional victory, one that would catapult them to their third winning season in a row. When Lafayette hits the field in 1984, it will be with the confidence built from a winning tradition. The coaching staff will have recruited another group of talented high school athletes, and the Leopards will have a bigger, stronger squad forged by a vigorous off-season weight training program. Returning veterans will provide the experience and leadership, and a wide-open style will once again provide Lafayette fans with gridiron excitement. Momentum is building for Leopard Fever in 84. Catch it. Lafayette football will have an additional goal beginning in 1986 when they join with Holy Cross, Colgate, William & Mary, Bucknell, and Lehigh in the formation of the new Colonial League. In addition to a challenging league schedule, Leopard fans can look forward to independent battles with Army, Navy, and an ever-changing group of Ivy League opponents. It all adds up to an exciting decade of football in the 80s. Lafayette's campus overlooks the Delaware River from a residential section of Easton known as College Hill. And the 2,000 students that reside on this picturesque campus are assured of three things: a great education, an active social life, and beating Lehigh in football. The Board of Trustees guarantees the first. The Interfraternity Council guarantees the second. But only hard work can guarantee the third. Lafayette football players began that commitment to beating the Engineers in the heat of the summer of 84. And in a cool, crisp November afternoon, Coach Bill Russo's Leopards amassed for that holy crusade that began 100 years ago. This rivalry dwarfs all others, as Lafayette and Lehigh have met 120 times, with the Pards holding a 65-49 advantage. 1984 found Lafayette fielding one of its youngest teams in recent memory, with only four senior starters. Lafayette's record-setting All-American quarterback, Frank Novak, was in the training camp of the Buffalo Bills. In All-East fullback, Craig Williams was on the New England Patriots roster. But here, in front of 20,000 fans, in the friendly confines of Fisher Field, Lafayette, with a win, could finish at 5-5 and banish Lehigh to a losing record. Lines were drawn, and the battle for football supremacy in the Valley was underway. The Lafayette offense had gone through a transformation in 1984, but the Leopards dusted off a vintage Frank Corbo for the big one. Junior tailback Ryan Priest from Mechanicsburg would run himself into the record book before the day was over. But the prophecy in the Hill was that a freshman would lead them, backed up by a defense with thunder in each fist. Dan Donnelly, 6 feet, 250 pound middle guard. Mike King, 6 foot, 2 inch, 260 pound tackle, a 3-year starter from Butler, Pennsylvania. Number 75, Steve Dunbar at 6 feet, 2, 270 pounds, and number 68, Kevin McCartney, as a designated pass rusher. Jim Brown, number 37, dealt out some of the biggest hits of the season. The team leader in sacks was number 53, Charles Brantley, from Springfield, Massachusetts. The linebackers included Frank Gaziano, number 51, who recorded a team-high 122 tackles and 4 interceptions. Defensive captain John Anderson from Queens, New York, patrolled the other linebacker slot in this, his third season as a starter. Dave Rankins from Rahway, New Jersey, anchored the secondary from safety and led the team in interceptions with 6, along with Stan Quiniski, Joe Yannick, Bruce Dixon, and Allentown freshman Mike Joseph. This secondary posted the warning: off limits to receivers. The penalty is, this wrecking crew may well have decided the game on the goal line in the first quarter.
the goal line. Intercepted by Lafayette. That's Kwanitsky at the 9-yard line, tackled by the intended receiver when he fed. And again, the Leopard defense comes up big.
With the wind at their back, Lafayette opened it up in the second quarter. And with freshman quarterback Jim Johnson at the controls, Lafayette was off and flying.
Where have all the good men gone, and where are all the gods? Where's the street-wide earth beneath the tide rising on? Isn't there a white night upon the pirate sea? Late at night I push and I turn and I dream of what I see.
Special teams players smelled the blood and, like hungry cats at feeding time, tore into any white jersey that moved. The offensive line of Clark, Thatcher, Gilbertson, Horn, and Gaziano and Parsons pounded the engineer front seven for 280 yards rushing and cleared the deck for Johnson's barrage through the air. With fullback Nick Kuyos leading the way, the Leopards owned the corner and the route was on.
Johnson hands the ball off to Ryan Priest outside, 45, 15, 40, Ryan Priest is gone, 60 yards and a touchdown, another quick.
Holy cow.
Ryan Priest rushed for 174 yards on his way to 1,111 yards in the season, climbing to within 300 yards of the career rushing record at Lafayette. The Lafayette defense held the engineers to 72 yards rushing and kept them scoreless till 4 minutes remained. Lafayette will graduate leading career receiver Frank Corbeau and all-time leading scorer Nick Kuyos. But the Leopards will return 18 starters including 10 of 11 on defense. The Pards have never had a losing season under head coach Bill Russo. And the assault on the record book continues with the return of Ryan Preece, chosen as team captain for 1985. The Leopards added another honor as Jim Johnson became the first freshman to win the Most Valuable Player Award in the Lehigh game. Lafayette seniors ended their careers with a 3-1 record against Lehigh and an overall four-year mark of 27-14. That winning tradition will continue in 1985 against a strong schedule that includes Navy, Colgate, Lehigh, Rhode Island, and New Hampshire. The Leopards will be ready. The 1985 version of Lafayette College football had kicked off the season with a crushing 20-7 victory over the University of New Hampshire. A fired-up defense held New Hampshire's Andre Garin under 100 yards for the first time in 14 games. And the Leopards rode the 100-yard rushing performance of tailback Ryan Preece to the 1-0 record. The Pards were home in game two for their annual war with Colgate. And head coach Bill Russo and a near-capacity Parent State crowd were raring to go. After an early Colgate touchdown, senior Darryl Green gave Lafayette good field position in the following kickoff. And he was a toenail away from breaking the big one. Jim Johnson from North Attleboro, Massachusetts, spread the wealth with a passing attack based on balance. Gordy Bullock, a senior flanker, caught this one for 10. The screen to Craig Parsons, the 6'2", 230-pound fullback, yielded 10 more. Parsons had been converted from tight end, where he had started the previous 3 years. Then Johnson to Green for a 25-yarder over the middle. But a missed field goal ended the opening threat. As the first quarter ended, one game plan faltered, but another was beginning to assert itself. Oh, Jim Johnson with Colgate playing pass went to the option play. First, Johnson executed the keep for a 15-yard gain. Coaches in the box signaled down for more of the same. Then behind a crushing knockdown block by Parsons, co-captain Ryan Preece took the option pitch for an additional 10. In the safety of a leak-proof pocket, Johnson, sensing all receivers were covered, folded to the 1-yard line behind a crushing crackback block by Bullock. From there, finesse took a back seat as Preece powered over for the touchdown. Like a pack of hungry cats at feeding time, Lafayette's defense used pursuit and gang tackling to stem the explosive Colgate offense. Number 58, co-captain John Anderson patrolled the flank for strays and, along with a few of his friends, greeted each ball carrier with the same cordial welcome. Defensive tackle Mike King recorded one of his team record 11 sacks in the same straight-ahead style, no detours for subtleness. The rest of the defense followed suit. Despite the ferocity of their effort, the Leopards found themselves trailing in the third quarter. It was now the Leopards' must mount a rally. A Johnson to Carl St. Bernard completion on the bootleg had the Pards flying high again.